Have you ever screwed in a light bulb, expecting it to glow, only to see nothing happen? And wonder if the whole thing was dead, or if there was still a way to bring it back? When that bulb didn't light up, I almost tossed it straight into the trash. But something felt off. The base looked fine, the wiring looked fine, and I kept thinking there had to be a way to bring it back. So I pulled out a small screwdriver, opened the cover, and took a closer look at the LED board inside. That was the moment I realized the bulb might not be dead at all. Sometimes it's just one tiny chip on the board that stops working, and once you know how to find it, you can fix the whole bulb in a few minutes. If you enjoy saving money and repairing things with your own hands, this is a simple project you can do right at your workbench. To start checking the faulty bulb, you can make a simple pair of test tweezers right at home. Take a piece of thick copper wire and strip both ends so the copper is clean. Bend the wire into a tight U shape that feels firm in your hand. Now place each tip on fine sandpaper and sharpen them until both ends come to a neat point. This helps the tips touch each LED chip without slipping. When you're done, you'll have a safe and steady tool that gives you good contact with the small pads on the circuit board. This homemade tweezer lets you test every LED one by one and quickly find the chip that stopped working. Tell me where you're watching from. I always enjoy seeing the different cities and states you're tuning in from. Once you have the homemade tweezers ready, take the first broken bulb and open the top cover with a utility knife. Keep your hands steady and work slowly so you do not crack the housing. Plug the LED board into your power source, then use your tweezers to touch each LED chip one by one. When you touch the bad chip, the rest of the LEDs will light up so you know exactly which one failed. Mark that spot, unplug the board, and scrape the damaged chip off the surface with your knife. Take an empty Coca-Cola can and cut out a small section from the side wall. Use your utility knife carefully and keep your fingers clear so you stay safe. Trim the piece down until you have a thin strip you can bend easily. Fold this strip into a small clip shape so it can press firmly against the contact point on the LED board. Make sure the edges are smooth enough to handle. This little piece of aluminum will act as the bridge that helps you reconnect the damaged LED spot on the first bulb. Now that you've identified the bad LED and prepared the small Coca-Cola metal strip, you can put the bulb back together. Start by placing the round circuit board back into the base of the bulb. Hold the metal strip so it makes firm contact with the spot where the damaged LED used to sit. This helps bridge the connection that was lost when the chip failed. Once the strip is sitting flat and touching the metal pad, press the board back into its original position. Make sure nothing is loose. After that, install the bulb into the socket and switch on the power. If the contact is good, the bulb will light up right away and you'll know your repair worked. This simple trick lets you bring a dead LED bulb back to use without replacing the entire light. Now you take the second broken bulb and repeat the same careful steps. You open the plastic cover with your utility knife and pull the round LED board out so you can test it. Hook it up to your power source and use your homemade copper tip tweezers to touch each LED one by one. Keep your hands dry and stay clear of exposed contacts because you are working with live current. When you touch the bad LED, the rest of the board will light up for a moment. That tells you exactly which chip has failed. Mark that spot, unplug the board, and scrape the damaged LED off the surface with the tip of your knife. Once the pad is clean, heat up your soldering iron and place a small drop of solder right where the LED used to sit. Let the solder flow until it bonds to the copper trace under it. Give it a few seconds to cool down so the board stays flat. Now that you've removed the faulty LED chip and cleaned the spot, you can put the bulb back together. Take a moment to look over the board and make sure the solder has cooled and settled properly. Once everything looks solid, place the board back into the housing and seat it the same way it came out. Press the cover on firmly so it locks into place. When you screw the bulb into the socket again, keep your hand on the switch and power it on. If the repair took, the light will come on right away and stay steady. It's a simple fix that brings a dead bulb back to life and saves you from throwing out something that can still work. When you look at both bulbs shining again, it feels good knowing you brought them back with a few simple steps and tools you already have at home. Fixing these LED bulbs is not difficult once you learn how to check each chip, make a clean contact, and use a small solder repair when needed. If you enjoy practical projects like this and want more ideas that save money and keep your tools working longer, make sure you subscribe and follow. Your next repair might be even easier than you think.